So Dana, what was it about Happy that really drew you towards the film?
Happy herself drew me towards the film. The character, the way it was etched out, the way Mudassar had written her and created her, and I mean, he almost like, he's been working on this script for about, I think, 2 years is what he said. And he's really gone into the detail, and you know, in terms of even the story. There's two aspects to it. Then the answer would have to be the character and the story equally. I can't pick one over the other. The story is the first thing that actually got me to even go and meet Mudassar and Anand sir, because somebody gave me a one-liner. My manager gave me a one-liner. Said, you know, this movie's about this girl who's getting married, Amritsari girl who runs away from a wedding. And who has this plan, you know, this escape plan or whatever, but then the plan goes wrong and she ends up in Pakistan. That's all I knew about it, and that's this one thing that was like, I was like, what? How does that even happen? Is that logistically possible? How did she land up in Pakistan? What happens after that? And I wanted to know more, and that's when I met Mudassar and Anand, and they went through the script with me, they went through the character with me, and it sealed the deal, because for me also I thought about it, and I was like, I never intended to play this kind of a role. Like in the beginning, after I had done Cocktail, I thought I'd stick to, you know, Cocktail kind of characters, because I knew that I would be able to pull that off. I knew that I could do it. It was in my comfort zone. It was my space. So that was like my mindset. And then suddenly I came across this script with this girl, and she was just completely the opposite. And I said, why not give this a shot and challenge myself? I know it'll be hard, but it's not impossible. It's just about working on it and doing, you know, prep for it or whatever. And that's how I went about it. So it'll be a great difference and change and variation from what I've done before.
You won a lot of acclaim for your character in Cocktail. Despite the presence of Deepika, you stood out in the film. So what kept you away from Bollywood for 2 years?
Nothing specific. Like, I feel like everybody's kind of misinterpreted my absence. Even though I wouldn't call it like complete absence, because it's not like I left the country or something. I was very much sure. I was working, but I didn't do a film, but I was doing other work. And I was simultaneously meeting people and actively working on trying to find my next project. It's just that it took me slightly longer, and maybe I wasn't pushy enough, but then that's just the nature of my character. Like, that's just how I am. It's my personality. I'm not really like, you know, I'm not overbearing and too pushy, and I feel like if somebody feels like I would fit, they would, you know, eventually reach out. I would never want to be in a situation where I'm almost like forcing somebody to cast me. So I guess that was my mindset, and still is. And then slowly, so maybe it took me longer for various reasons, but I eventually met Mudassar and Anand, and that was about a year and a half ago. So when you say 4 years, you go to minus 1.5 years. And that's how long. Yeah.
But you have to share what exactly you were doing in the...
I mean, I was modeling. I was, you know, doing my brand stuff, appearances. I was traveling. I, you know, there's a few things that interest me here and there in my personal space. So I was just doing...
Any big films which you rejected or something like that?
There was a few. Yeah, there was quite a few things that came my way. But I just felt that at that time, it wasn't the right thing for me. I mean, I'm not at all being judgmental about the films or the scripts or any of it. It's just something that didn't appeal to me, which is a very personal decision. And so I thought I'd wait it out. And, you know, there was no hurry for me. Like, in my mind, I didn't have an agenda to follow or, like, a timeline to keep, you know, stick to. I said, I'll take my time with it. And I didn't see that as, like, the end of the world. It was just unconventional. But it was not wrong, necessarily. It was just another way of going about things.
You know, very few people
being well received, and everyone's loving your character in the film, and especially the dialect which you have used. How did you get that perfectly? You know, that scene when you were talking with the tunnel.
Yeah, so when I finally decided to take up this challenge, literally, to play Happy, I spoke to Mudassar and Anand at that time, and I said, listen, I like to be upfront and honest with, you know, things right in the beginning, so that there's no problem later on as we go along. And I know my strengths and my weaknesses. My strength is to prep and to take time with a script, with a character, you know, go into a bit of detail, have somebody work with me on it in case that it requires, you know, the script requires that. But you need to give me that time to prep. I cannot, it's not like I met you now and then I sign and then like you say we need to start shooting next month. That I cannot do. Like, I need that 2 months or 3 months or whatever it is. And I mean, I'm very upfront about it. So I spoke to them, I said, I need that. Can you give me that much time? And they said, yes, we have that time, because they were still setting up and, you know, getting the stuff, going on recce, and it was still right at the beginning of the whole process for them as well. And Madhasar put me on to somebody. She's an actor called Nilima Sharma, who has now become my friend. But he knew her really well. He knows her well. And he felt like she was the kind of fit in terms of, you know, she's Punjabi herself from Jalandhar. So she's got that, you know, that Punjabiness to her, from the way she dresses, the way she speaks, her, you know, mannerisms, her, you know, small things like actions and, you know, the various nuances. And so for me, it was more like the first few times I met her, I was literally just sitting and watching her, because I didn't have to say much. She just, like, from beginning to end, she just rattled off things, and she was like, and I was like, wow, I really need to work a lot to get there, to be able to, you know, be that kind of character and personality, and, you know, for the film at least. So we worked together. We kind of structured a way of going about it. We decided she would tell me, send me reference videos to watch. You know, she'd send me links to read. She'd say, you know, coming from Punjab, this is what we do. This is how we do, how we celebrate the more cultural aspects of, you know, the dances. And like, she actually taught me some like really local folk dance stuff. So I think that all helped a lot, and even the diction and stuff she helped me with. So I definitely didn't come out of nowhere.
Actresses get a female-centric, a film based on the female character in early stage of their careers. How do you see this, that your second film is centered?
I'm very on, like, I feel humbled about it, because you're right. Having said that, I'm going to be honest and say that this is a fully ensemble cast, and it's not like it's only about one person. It is the title role, yes, but everybody has come together to make this movie happen. It's not, you know, I feel like we are, all the characters are equally important. They've all been sketched really well, and, you know, they all have their quirks and eccentricities, and they all are interesting. So I feel like this movie is about everybody. It's not really about one person, but yes, it is the title role, and it's centered around, you know, her.
Yeah.
So it is very humbling, actually, because I realized how, you know, what a great opportunity it was for me. And also, I feel the other thing that I really liked about it, and I was, again, thought that it was a great opportunity to have, is to play a strongish character compared to the first one, especially. Like, Meera was this really subdued,
yeah,
you know, quiet girl next door. You know, you could kind of, be wrong to say you could walk all over her, but you know what I mean. Like, she had that soft side, whereas, yeah, demure is the right word. Whereas this one is none of that. Like, she will not take nonsense. You know, she will put you in her in your place, and may you, for your own good, better not come in her way, that kind of character. You know, bold, strong, independent, opinionated. It was just nice to play something like that, which is a slightly stronger character in, you know, today's world. And yeah, it felt good to have that opportunity in my second film.
Yeah, but
so
talking about strong, I read somewhere that you actually saved Ali's life because you got drowned somewhere in...
I don't know where that came about from. That's absolute nonsense.
That's
so
that
dramatically ridiculous. Yeah.
So but did he actually fall into the...
No,
no.
No. None of that happened. I read half this stuff and I'm like, I call up and imagine that. Do I have like memory lapse or
because
I don't remember this happening when it happened.
I thought that was something strong.
No. And I don't even mean physical strength as much as I meant, you know,
yeah,
strong.
Right.
I mean, like, she's just like mentally,
yeah,
you know, all that.
So with Cocktail, you established a connection with the audience. So I don't know how else to term it, but with your absence, do you think as an actor it gets difficult for you to go back to the sets and face the camera, or are you worried about the audience, that how will you reconnect with them?
So you're asking two questions.
Yeah.
One is on set. Yeah, I imagine it would be very tough for me to go back on set after all these years, and because I've not, like I said, I've not done a movie in between. So it would be again my first movie experience after like three years, whatever it was. And I imagine that I was actually very worried about it. But strangely, it turned out to be the opposite for me. I think because of this time that I've spent, you know, and I, like I said, I hadn't stopped working completely. I was still meeting a lot of people. I was still modeling and doing like all that kind of work. And so along the way came a certain confidence, and also came a certain, like, I got used to being in this world. Like, Cocktail for me was like, I suddenly got thrown into this, you know, world of being in the limelight and being a public personality and people recognizing you where you went, you know. So it took a while to adjust to that. And then the few years that I was kind of in it but not so much in the spotlight gave me the chance to get more used to it and, you know, get comfortable with it. So suddenly when I went for this shoot, like, and I was across in front of the camera, I was like, okay, the first few days, maybe, actually not even the first few days, the first day took a little getting used to and, like, getting back into the groove of it. And then after that, I was just fine. In fact, I feel like I overcame my inhibitions that I had in the first movie. Every time I'd go in front of the camera and be scared. Here, somehow I just managed to switch off the fact that there was a camera there and there was 500 people standing around watching. I was just managed to get into the scene and not be so conscious of that. So that's one part of your question. Secondly, yes, I do feel that it is a scary feeling, because, I mean, it's only human nature, out of sight, out of mind. So, you know, you wonder whether the audience will remember, or, you know, whether they accept you again, or, you know, whether they like you as much. It's a completely different kind of character. So, you know, maybe Meera works, does Happy work? We don't know yet. So, yeah, there is stuff like that in my mind. And I don't have enough time to actually dwell into it and think about it, because we're so busy doing all of this stuff. But yeah, it does occur to me sometimes, and I just kind of hope it goes well.
Will we see you doing more films now? And have you been offered any script after this?
I've been meeting people actively, and I definitely don't want it to be as long. Maybe now I up my game a bit. And I want to try finding something faster, of course, because I don't want that to be too much of a gap.
What is it exactly we were looking out for? In a script or something?
Again, it would be the story for me, and a good role, like, character wise. I think about it and I'm like, why not do something again that's completely different? You know, it would be a nice path to follow, since I've already started that way. So do this really demure girl to this really, like, outspoken, loud chick, to something completely, like, maybe a different genre altogether, like, you know, maybe a thriller or, like, some hardcore action flick or something that's, like, not expected again. And that's also something that would keep my interest going. Like, for me, I need to not get bored along the way. Like, I need to be doing things that are constantly exciting or interesting to me. So
will you be open to the web series and everything? You know, people are trying out something different genre like that.
I mean, I'm open to good content. So if there is something that's, you know, content-wise great, character-wise great, and it's a good setup, then I don't see why not. Because, you know, the way Netflix does stuff, or, you know, it's projected really well, and not projected, what's the word, but it's, what do you
presented.
Call it? Presented. And the setup is really, it's presented. Yeah, I go with that. So yeah, then why not? I mean, I don't want to restrict myself to, like, saying, you know, it's not even right to say I'll never do that, because you never know. Along the way, things change, and people's approaches change, and it might be a cool thing to do.
So can we say that you are very choosy about your roles?
Yes, you can say that to a certain extent, because I wouldn't do anything that just came my way. But it's also a personal choice. It's not like, I'm not saying it in a way where I'm judgmental of the stuff that's coming to me and I say, oh, I think that's really bad. It's just that I feel it's not right for me. Because I know my strengths and weaknesses, and I know that I need to be interested in what I'm doing. And if I'm not interested, by default, I'm not going to give it 100%. So then what's the point? It doesn't become worth it.
So can you give us some examples, you know, in the span when you were not there, any of the films which you saw and you feel like, gosh, you know, I would have done that role or something else?
You know, the last few years, there's been so many movies that have been made that have been so nice, in terms of, like, there's been a change in the content and the presentation, and not completely mainstream, but somewhere in the middle where it's, you know, that nice, that right balance of content and yet being commercial. And I would love to do stuff like that. So, I mean, like, I've been saying this a lot, but only because I can't think of any more. But there's, like, been Piku, there's been NH10, there's been, you know, I really even like Shahid and Lunchbox. And those are much earlier, I know they're older, but in the recent past, I guess I'd have to say Pico and NHL were really nice, like good kind of films that gripped me, and that's what I find interesting.
Dennis, since the release of the film is just around the corner, give us your 5 reasons to watch the film
Constitution. Well, it's a family entertainer. We've got a clear U certificate.
Yeah.
So, you know, in this day and age, I think that's quite, like, it's quite cool because, like, the whole family can go and watch it together. Nobody's going to be feeling weird or awkward about it at any point. Oh, so that's one. It's quirky. You know, I feel like it's the kind of comedy that's not what you expect. It's not that typical slapstick comedy, and yet there's a story, and it's very sweet. It's a sweet story. And it's very fast paced, so you don't have the option to get bored. those are enough reasons.
Have you signed anything?
Not yet, I'm looking at a few things, but I haven't signed.
Has Anandana offered you anything under his production or direction after this?
Not yet, we're all still focusing on Happy and waiting for the 19th, so let's wait and see how that goes.
Thank you so much.
And
all the best.
And all the best
for the film.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. What do I have to say?
Just watch the interviews and reviews of read of reviews and interviews of Happy Bhatia in
Cinemarkets. Watch and read the interviews of Happy Bhatia on Cinemarkets. Can you do the same for me, please? The Indian movie channel.
Damn, guys.
You can say, go and watch Happy Bhatia. Releasing on whatever day on the 19th, and all the best to the Indian Movie Channel.
All the best
to the Indian Movie Channel.
Okay.
You must go watch Happy Bhatia Jaggi releasing on the 19th of August, and all the best. To